The problems of Nigeria are not from the north, south, east or west. They are not from our differences in tribe, culture or social orientations. The problems are from the 201 million Nigerians that have been and continue to tolerate, endure and be silent to the gross misrule by the less than 10,000 persons to whom we have entrusted our commonwealth. Our long silence as a people to those that continue to disrespect and disregard our constitution, where it is clearly stated that the primary purpose of government is the provision of welfare and security for the people. Fellow Nigerians, it is very unfortunate that at this time of our national political and security tragedies, Nigerians are already campaigning to be president in 2023. Today, I would like to address such persons that are already campaigning for 2023. They have no interest in joining to fix the many problems besetting our country now. That is enough to gauge their level of patriotism. Politicians who live as if tomorrow is a promise. Abacha stole and was dreaming of becoming civilian president until God suddenly plucked him away at the age of 55. That is the only Nigerian leader whose death caused Nigerians to jubilate and to celebrate. Anybody that has contributed to the present woes in our country will surely go down the Abacha way for Nigeria to move on. You can begin your campaign, but I believe that some of you that have plunged Nigeria into the present state of decadence will definitely not live to see 2023. It is becoming clearer in the day that the present Nigerian government has no practicable and reliable plans to take away 13.2 million children from the streets. No plan to provide steady electricity. Nigerians are still paying for darkness and estimated bills. No plans to eradicate poverty, malnutrition, and malaria. With mosquitoes everywhere, the Nigerian government claimed that they have used $16 million to fight malaria by buying mosquito nets. Mosquito nets. Mosquito nets. $16 million. They claim that they have shed the $320 million Abacha loot on the poor, that they shed 500 billion naira as trader money in the name of social investment program and all that nonsense. Yet, nothing has changed. No verifiable record to show how these monies were spent or how they have improved the lives of our people. We just read about billions and billions and billions being spent on newspaper. Yet, 2023 presidential aspirants continue to disregard our national concerns and begin senseless campaigns and stupid endorsements for 2023. In 1974, China had 700 million persons that were living in extreme poverty. But one man, just one leader, Deng Xiaoping, stood up with other patriotic politicians and their story changed. Here we are promoting and dividing ourselves with religion and ethnicity when the world is moving on and leaving us behind. New legislators and members of executives are there receiving the same insane salaries in the midst of monumental hardship and borrowing to finance our national budget. Yet you are there silent, waiting for 2023. Those that were sponsored to contest for the 2019 elections are equally waiting again to contest in 2023. We are waiting for all of you. The United Nations General Assembly has projected that in the year 2050, 80% of the world's poorest people will be living in Africa. 40% of that number will be in Nigeria, and the other 40% will be living in the Democratic Republic of Congo. These two countries are one of the most blessed, endowed countries in the world in terms of natural endowment. And sadly, It means that the continuing silence of Nigerians, we shall remain the world poverty capital beyond 2050. That is a projection of the United Nations General Assembly. Nigeria will remain the poverty capital beyond 2050. By 2050, if God permits, I will be 83 years. This is 2019. It means that if Nigerians refuse to act now, all our efforts at national reconstruction may just be wasted. God forbid. God forbid. And this is the struggle that people have been struggling for years. Some of them have died. It means that the labor of our heroes past will be in vain. And when the activists that are alive now, we die. People will escort them to their graves crying, "Do you know there is another fellowship in heaven?" And others will chorus, "I know there is another fellowship in heaven." They will sing again, "Do you know there is another fellowship in heaven? I know there is another fellowship in heaven." God forbid. Our labor shall not be in vain. Nigeria is in our hands. Nigeria is in our hands. Fellow Nigerians, we must ensure that we fellowship here on earth in peace and prosperity before we talk about the fellowship in heaven. On Judgment Day, if angels ask you, "What did you do with your natural resources?" what will you answer? That you tolerated inept politicians throughout your life? No. No. If Nigeria will remain the poverty capital of the world by 2050, let us do a simple mathematics. Nigerians born since 1960, you are born into a developing country. Okay. It will remain a developing country beyond 2050 because Nigerians have refused to protest against misrule. Right? Okay. Now, 2050 is 31 years from now, because we are talking now in 2019. Right? Meaning that somebody born in 1960 will be 90 years by 2050 in a generation that will now be termed a wasted generation. Meaning that a child born in Nigeria today has been born into the poverty capital and will be living all through poverty till 2050 and 50 and beyond. Look at it from another dimension. A tenure for a president in Nigeria lasts for 4 years. In the year 2050, that will be 35 years, 31 years from now, divided by 4, you now have 7.75. So let's say 7 presidents would have ruled between now and 2050. Right? Okay. It means that if Nigeria continues to tolerate the current lack of welfare and security, 7 more Nigerian presidents from now will not be able to take us out of poverty. It will even worsen. This number includes those dreaming, those aspirants that are dreaming now to campaign for 2023. This present poverty is what you get when you choose your leaders based on tribe, based on religion, based on the so-called party zoning formula. You don't get the best people coming out. This will continue if Nigerian youths continue to focus on cultism and political thuggery. It will continue and come to pass if the National Association of Nigerian Students continue to play selfish politics with the government of the day. This nonsense will come to pass if the Nigerian Labour Congress, Nollywood musicians, civil society organizations, and the rest of Nigerians continue to celebrate this ongoing hardship from recycled leaders. Nigeria will never develop unless we embark on a revolution without ammunition by beginning a civil disobedience where we shall arrest our failed looters and their failed policies. A time must come when we must storm out their houses to the schools and hospitals that they refuse to build. A time must come when we shall turn their many jeeps to ambulances, for the hospitals that they continue to neglect by traveling abroad for treatment. Every living child of a failed politician will be questioned by us in the near future because you benefited from where your parents looted. So if your father or mother is among those in government now, know in your mind that you have questions to answer in the future if they don't change now, if they don't change for good. You better advise them for your own good. With all of these problems, if you are focusing on contesting elections in 2023 without making any effort to practically contribute to solving our problems now, then you must be really, really ashamed of yourself. Remember the words of Liberty Hyde Bailey. A garden requires patient labor and attention. Plants do not grow merely to satisfy ambitions or to fulfill good intentions. They thrive because someone expended effort on them. God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria.